in from beautiful Virginia. It's absolutely spectacular. It's clear and sunny and just a little bit on the cool side, like maybe about 70. It's perfect. And as you have probably heard too many times before, it's definitely buzzing around this farm in preparation for the leadership retreat that's going to take place in just a couple of weeks. And if you could see with your own eyes the transformation and the work that's been done and the work that still has to be done, it would blow your mind. When you take on big things in this life, whether it's a transformation of a barn or the building of a business, you're forever surrounded by people that just don't believe, frankly. Either they can't believe what they're seeing or they don't believe things are possible. Perhaps your circle of family or friends don't believe that you'll ever build this business or that you should even be trying to build this business, right? Those people are everywhere. It takes determination. There's no doubt about that. And it takes a big why. The biggest factor in success, the very thing that sets some people aside from all the others in terms of how far and how high they climb in life, the very thing that made Bill Gates a Bill Gates, or Michael Jordan, Michael Jordan, or Martin Luther King, Martin Luther King, or even Mr. O, Mr. O, isn't just hard work and a big why. The difference for all of them, including me, is understanding power. So the journey for this event and everything surrounding it has inspired this message for you today entitled, The Paradigm Shift is Power. I believe that most people go through this life, sadly, like wussies, and they live more like victims than victorious ones. We can blame self-confidence. There's no doubt about that. People have had different journeys, things that have, robbed them of their confidence, if you will. We can point the finger, certainly at fear anytime we feel like it, right? We can say that we're not equipped, we don't know how, we're not smart enough. We got all kinds of things we can say. But the biggest problem, the thickest roadblocks you face, the reason you aren't moving forward is that you don't believe that you have the power to win. The paradigm shifts in power. So what is power? Well, it should come as no surprise to you as a woman of faith. I focus on the use of power coming from the Bible. And that word is derived from the Greek word dynamis, a word that actually in English comes out, is derived into the word dynamite. Outside of a nuclear weapon, I'm not sure anybody of you could, come up with anything that you could think of as being more powerful than a stick of dynamite, right? If you throw a stick of dynamite into any situation, you're going to see change, that's for sure. Naturally, power or dynamite can be used for destruction. We're not talking about that. But power that comes from a stick of dynamite is the source of good things. You have the power to have good relationships, with your significant other, with your family members, with your friends. You have the power to do that. If that's not possible, you have the power to move on in your life. Fear and all those things that get in the way of you believing that you have power are the reason you stay stuck where you are. You have the power to raise up good children. You have the power to walk out your faith in ways you never even imagined before. And you have the power to build a great success. The Bible's filled with the most powerful ideas in this world, no doubt about that. But if you just think about substituting the word dynamite, if you know for the word power, they're interchangeable, you can begin to understand the greatness of it. For instance, there's a verse when Jesus was calling his 12, disciples together, his A team, right? He called them together and he gave them the power or the dynamite and the authority to drive out demons and cure diseases. He gave them the same power that he has, and you've got the same power within you. And in praying for his followers, he said, Holy Father, protect them by the power of your name. Can you imagine how powerful the name of God is if you consider that it means like a stick of dynamite, right? When you're up against a tough situation, it's essential, of course, to stand up to it. It's to face it, to think about it, to study it, pray about it, if you will, and then hit it and keep after it. You have within you enough force put there by God Almighty to overcome situations that otherwise seem overwhelming. Guys, honestly, if you look at this farm project with a normal human eye, with human nature, if you will, you would say it not only doesn't make sense, it's not possible. Well, sure isn't possible for me. I don't have anything to accomplish this in my own will, right? I'm a 60-year-old woman, for heaven's sake. I have limitations. I have limited resources. There's absolutely nothing about me or my life that would get this project done. It's not me, right? But I know and I understand power. And because God says I have power, right? So when he tells me to do something, I don't wander around thinking about all the details necessarily. I just say, hey, let's go do it because God says so. And I know I have the power to succeed. I have the power to persevere. I have the power to choose to take on difficult situations and win. I have dynamite within me that can propel me to success in any situation. And you know, my life reflects it. I understand the power that I already have, and I tap that dynamite whenever I need to. I don't have to, you know, have what it took to be a single mom. I didn't have it. I didn't have a good foundation. I'd never been a mom before. I had no stinking clue, right? I didn't have that what it took to raise up four kids by myself, to feed them and clothe them and nurture them without help. But I knew that I had the power within me to tackle and succeed at all of it. I believed it. Understand power is empowering. Understanding power drives out fear. How can you be fearful if you really believe you have the power to succeed? Understanding power builds confidence. How can you run around like a wussy if you know you've got power within you? You're not going to be fearful of those things, right? But we let the mind get in the way of the believing. You know, we can talk ourselves out of the most amazing things. I could have so easily done it with this farm mission, I'll tell you. You know, I could have said, well, that's a nice dream. It's just not possible. It's only me. I have a limit. I can't get out there and do that. But, you know, I didn't talk myself out of it. I tapped into the power. And you know what happened? God sent everything we needed, from people with big hearts and big hands to the finances and everything we need. I understand power. We can let the mind, though, tell us that we're powerless, can't we? Many of you do that. You know, that you say, well, you know, I'd really like to build this business, but I don't know how to do this, or I don't know how to do that, or I'm not bold, or I don't have a lot of friends, or I get scared. We can tell ourselves that we're powerless, but that's never true. Consider stories that you've heard at some point. I'm going to switch up gears just to paint a picture for you. You know, maybe it was a story about someone that got trapped under a car, for instance, and in a split second, superhuman strength showed up, and a 4,000-pound car was lifted to save a life. Now, we could look outside that situation and dissect it and say, that's not possible for a man to lift a 4,000-pound car. It's not physical power that we're seeing there. It's the power that's being tapped into. But if that hero had taken the time to do what most of us do with our business, you know, consider the circumstances, you know, how could I do that? Well, I don't know. Let me think about it. If he had taken any time whatsoever, he would have convinced himself that it wasn't possible to single-handedly lift a 4,000-pound car, and the person would have died under the weight. That's just a simple example of power, what it looks like when you light that dynamite. It's a glimpse of what things are, you know, all the things that are possible when you don't let your mind is going to be like a septic field when you don't let your mind convince you that you're a wussy, you have no control over your life. You know, you have the power and control over your relationships, your children, your faith, and absolutely your business. You know, as a single mom, you know, who spent a lot of time ministering to other single moms over the years, mostly, I think, because I was seen as a survivor. And frankly, I survived well. I can tell you that the fact that these women didn't believe that they had the power to change their lives usually destroyed whatever life they had left. They either didn't believe that they had the power to change the circumstances in the relationship, or they didn't have the power to get out and survive on their own, to earn a living, if you will. They did not believe they had the power, and they destroyed whatever they had left. You throw a stick of dynamite into an abusive relationship, you will see some powerful change one way or the other, right? Tap into the power that is already within you, and you'll walk with confidence, determination, and you'll build a different life. The paradigm shift is always power. You know, another verse of the Bible talks about that the Holy Spirit will come upon you and give you power. You know, when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, you experience dynamite, right? And it's through that you make tremendous changes in this world, in the lives of other people. If you practice faith, you know, you're going to see that grow within you. But, you know, even people of faith struggle with it. They just think like wussies, and they think that they're victims, and they don't understand the power that's within them. You have the power to have a good, successful life. Nobody can do it for you. And it doesn't take learning more and more and more of what you already know to succeed at something. You already have it. You just got to get out, light that stick of dynamite. The common denominator behind every single super successful person on the planet is that they understand the power within them and they tapped into what they already had. You know, do you think that Bill Gates already knew how to, you know, build software? And he was, did you think he stumbled around in his parents' garage and came up with every reason he couldn't do what he did? He knew he had things to learn, no doubt, but he also understood the power. You think when Michael Jordan kept, you know, trying and failing, that, you know, he couldn't have told himself, listen, I'm giving this thing up. I obviously not good enough for this game. But he didn't. He knew he had the power within him to succeed. Look at Martin Luther King. He changed lives forever. He could have come up with every excuse imaginable for why he wasn't the man to send this message. But he went on because he understood the power. Or even think about in our world of Mr. O. You know, he had a lot of adversity, a lot of setbacks. What if he said, you know what, I'm too old, it's too complicated, I'm too broke. What if he never tapped into that power to accomplish what he accomplished? You and I wouldn't be here today. All these people are just men. You know, none of them exceptional in any other way, frankly, except for what they accomplished when they lit that stick of dynamite and threw it at their dream. You and I are no different than they are. We can tap into that power. Power, the paradigm shift is in the power. So, do you believe you have the power to have greatness in your life? Are you tired of running around like a wussy? You know, do you believe that you have the power to attract good relationships or to raise good children or to be a useful Christian or to build an empire in your business? I'm going to tell you with absolute certainty you do. If you tap into the power that's already within you. All that other stuff's just details. You see, power is empowering. And again, power drives out fear, it builds confidence, and it breaks down barriers. It overcomes, and it has the potential to blow your life up into greatness. I want you to think about power, and if you try to tap what's already within you, you know, the mind is the place where we convince ourselves we can't lift that car off of a person being crushed under it. It's the mind that stops us. It's the mind that gets in the way. And it's the mind that will lie to you all day long that you can't go where you said you want to go. Having a why is one thing. Having a dream is one thing. Being willing to roll up your sleeves and work hard is another thing. But it's an entirely different story when you can embrace the fact that you absolutely have the power to succeed in every area of your life. So go eat your spinach like Popeye, get those muscles flexed, and more importantly, get inside your own head, kick out all those things that tell you you can't do what you can do, and try to embrace the power that's within you. I know you've got it. We all have it. If we'll just light that stick of dynamite and throw it at our business and every area of our life, we will succeed. So you guys go be blessed. You know, I'm looking forward to seeing some of you at the event here coming up in just a couple of weeks. And I'm also asking again, you know, for your prayers that everything will go as planned. Again, it's not my plan, okay? So when you pray, don't pray for me. Just pray for this plan. It's going to be a magnificent, life-changing event. How do I know that? Because I know that the power will be there. So you guys make it a great day. God bless you. I'll see you at the top, and I'll see you next week. Take care. Bye-bye.